I've been working really hard on my clothing line, She by Sheree.
Don't let them have more break in here.
Ed and I have put a lot of time and energy into doing this clothing line, Closet Freak.
You know, we want to do a fashion show, so let me see your stuff.
I think it's very interesting that Lisa has this very sudden interest in starting a clothing line.
Is this some of the stuff? I love this.
I'm glad that I can inspire some of the less fashionable people to become fashionable.
Sheree knows about fashion, but there's a lot of things that go into place instead of just knowing fashion. You have to be a business-minded person.
We know she's not that into fashion. It'd be fair to say that the designer is actually doing everything for Lisa. She's just a little copycat.
The sample can be made in a day or two.
Not a day or two like Sheree's.
Oh. Sheree's fashion show last year, she didn't have any clothes. Last time, dude, for real, you had a wonderful social thing. It was great.
So I get there, and they were like, there's no clothes.
The staff got to kick it out.
My staff?
Yeah, because you have to surround yourself with people that know what the f*** is.
I am a designer. I'm not into production. Dwight offered to come aboard and help me with my fashion show. So I decided to give him a chance.
I was a gift from God sent to Sheree to help her out in this.
I prefer to overkill than underkill. This is not a church convention.
It's not he by Dwight, it's she by Sheree.
It's taken Sheree 2 years to get it together. If I had 2 years, do you know what mine would look like?
I told you I'm coming!
I didn't see the show, but when I got there, I did see the piece that Lisa had on. And if it was any indication of what her show was like, I didn't miss a thing.
Okay. Well, Lisa, Angela from St. Louis said, Lisa, when the girls call you a copycat, how does that make you feel?
I was like, copycat? What, are we in second grade? I mean, we're like, what is that? Also, when I heard it, I actually thought it was funny. I mean, you're entitled to your opinion, but copycat? I've been doing this for years, so.
James from New York City said, how can Sheree pretend to be Lisa's friend and then show up at her fashion show after it was over and dress like she was headed to the mall?
I absolutely wanted to support Lisa, and Lisa knew, and everyone knew that my son had a concert. I wore jeans to my son's concert.
Right.
So I threw on a jacket and went to the show.
With your fashion show, you're really putting your faith into Dwight. Did you ever worry, what if I bet on the wrong horse here? What if I gave him too much access to this show?
Honestly, no. It was not just Dwight doing everything. I was still very much involved.
Dwight, you seemed really active in terms of altering the clothes.
Samples on a hanger is one thing, but when you put it on a body, it's something totally different. And they did look good on the hanger. And once we got the fit model, it was something else. And yes, I did. I called in major couturiers, and they came in the day of the show and fixed what the problem was. And that is what I do. I did things that she don't even know I did, didn't even ask her if I should do them. That's who I am, and that's how I roll, you know? And I think she appreciated, whether she does or not, I mean, she will in the long run.
I appreciated them, and I think the show, you know, turned out absolutely beautiful. I mean, I got a lot of positive feedback, a lot of great feedback.
Lisa, Gen C from Atlanta said, in retrospect, do you think Dwight had valid criticisms of your runway show?
No, because it wasn't a runway show. Actually, I had a fashion viewing. I had performances by Jay Holiday. I had Kitty's Litter. It was a performance, and I showed some of my passions on what's to come. So it wasn't like a runway show. So,
well, you had a runway.
Yeah, to show some of the fashion, of course, because how else would they show it? Where are they going to walk?
That's what you call a runway fashion show.
That no, but normally you don't have performances. I'm more artsy. I do it my way. You're entitled to your opinion. It's the way that you did it. It wasn't classy, it was very uncouth, and there's a time and place for everything, really. That's not being a friend.
That was very much of being a friend.
I wouldn't come to your salon while you're doing hair, or supposedly doing hair, no, and say, you know what, you're doing a horrible job, I think that's horrible, you can't do hair at all. That's not the time or the place. I'd probably take you to lunch and say, you know what, Dwight, you might want to take a few more classes.
We had never been out to lunch.
We haven't. But you could have invited me.
But Nene asked me at that time what I thought and what I felt, and that was my opinion of what my critique of that moment.
And so whether someone asks you to jump off a cliff, are you going to do that? So I think there's a time and place
for
everything.
We're talking about fashion. It's very much a fashion show. I don't know what terminology you want to use it, and you can use any terminology.
Where's your clothing line?
I don't have a clothing line. I do hair. Okay, but I go to shows all over the world.
And that's fine. It's fabulous. I demand respect because I give other people respect.
It was not about disrespect. I'm not as tactful as you would like for me to be, but I am who I am, and you are who you are.
Okay, and I can respect that. I just probably won't invite you to the next show.
Well, thank you. You didn't have to invite me to that one. Your horrible shows.